It's Greg McIntyre, Lawyer Greg, the Elder Law Guy with the Elder Law Report, and I have a great topic for you here today, and it's the 2018 tax laws, which I need to know with what I do, right, with estate planning. And the last time I had a question about the tax laws a few years back, Robbie set me straight. I mean, I could spit out those gifting, how they worked at death or in life, you know, and you're the one that set me straight on all that, right?
I remember.
Because when I need to know something, I go to someone who's in the know, and Robbie happens to be an accountant, and among other things, right? And really good with taxes, right? So does that for individuals and businesses. So we're very blessed to have Robbie Reynolds here today to comment on those issues.
Yes.
We have somebody. We have
your beautiful, beautiful wife.
Oh,
yes.
Live
and in person.
And Hayden?
Yes.
Will you pay my taxes for me next year?
Well, sure.
Sure?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what the tax laws are yet, so we're going to find out today, okay? So I wouldn't say yes yet, right? Yeah. If you don't make up to $25,000, you don't have to pay any taxes, so maybe I can just pay myself less than that.
Okay.
I don't know. But how does it affect us? How does it affect our businesses? How does it affect us individually? How does it affect a senior and their families? I don't know, but I think Robbie's going to get into that today. Hayden, did you have a happy place or anything prepared today?
No, I didn't. I thought I was going to. Mm-hmm. I was going to get a list of all the crazy taxes we have to pay. And then I started reading, and it got sober instead of the least bit happy. But the one thing that I think caught my attention, I have a granddaughter going to college this coming fall, and Greg has a son who's going to college. And I just happened to look at the gift tax. No, or university. No. Okay. I think my granddaughter's going to the University of Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
Because she's got scholarship money, and she's been working with her guidance counselors forever, so they've got that all figured out. But some scholarship money can be taxable, depending on what you spend it on. I just found that in my computer. It depends on whether you spend it on at an accredited school, and if it covers tuition, books, fees, or school supplies, that money is tax-free. But if it goes to travel, housing, or other miscellaneous expenses, it is taxable. So things like
definitely
that are good to know before
you parent or grandparents.
Yeah, yes. And these people who win the makeover housing and all
sure.
this kind of stuff, all of that is taxable
right.
if it's over $14,000 or something like that. So you may assume anything you want to. You may assume in your position, you know how people have assumed
mm-hmm.
and how it's gotten them into trouble. They didn't think they needed this or
right.
it didn't apply to them. So it's better to ask and get an answer from a professional than to assume. So we have a professional.
I know. So better to knowledge is power, right? So,
absolutely.
So we're going to get some knowledge. So Robbie, thank you for being here with us today. I appreciate it. Well, let's get down to it. So there's a new tax law in 2018, and my fear is that it canceled out everything I already know about taxes and how I'm planning. So what should we know?
Well, it didn't cancel everything out. It changed a lot of things.
Okay.
It changed a lot of things if you're a business. The way some of that income is going to be taxed, particularly if you're in a type of business, a sole proprietorship, a partnership, or LLC, or an S corporation, where profit is going to pass through to the business owner, the tax on that income is going to be significantly different than it has been in past years.
Okay.
Don't know for sure whether it's going to be better or worse. Some of the analysis we've done so far, it doesn't make much difference. Some, it makes a lot of difference. So it all depends on the individual situation. All that money ends up being taxed on your personal return, and the changes on the personal return don't seem to have a lot of big differences unless you're on the way on the top end or way down on the bottom end, income-wise. The tax brackets have gone down some, so generally we tend to be going to pay a little bit less in tax.
Mm-hmm.
Our standard deduction is going up, so most of us won't have to itemize our deductions, and we'll be in the same position, but we're losing our exemptions. So someone who has six children is going to have an increase in their taxable income because they won't have a $4,000 deduction for each of those dependents.
Wow,
anymore.
That's
That's not good.
24K.
Good. I don't like that.
That may discourage the birth rate. What we're looking at now is a less than 2.0 for family. Mm-hmm. We're not reproducing in some cases, so that's going to get worse.
So that's going to have an effect. The child care credit, or the child credit, mm-hmm. for each child under 17 is going to go up $5,000. And a good portion of that is going to be refundable in certain situations,
right,
depending on what income limitations apply. A lot of the income limitations in 2017 and before prevented a lot of people from really taking advantage of these. Those income limitations are going to increase, so that it'll be more available to more taxpayers altogether.
So pretty much I'm going to have to pay $24,000 more in taxes.
No, I didn't say that.
They're saying
we're going to lose
that
deductions of $24,000.
Was that right? That if you make up to, you're not taxed up to $25,000 in income? Is that right? Is that what I heard?
If you're married and you're filing a joint return,
yes,
then if you have income of $25,000,
okay,
then your tax should be zero.
Oh. Cool.
Or maybe 10% of
right,
$1,000.
Okay.
It's almost zero.
How does that compare with what the old rate was?
Well, at $24,000 previously, depending on what your exemptions and itemized deductions were, you probably would have paid 10% of the difference between $24,000 and, say, maybe $12,000. So you pay $1,200 compared to $100. Mm-hmm. On the very
low. I'm sorry, we got you off track there.
But that's
please
okay.
Keep going.
That's right. It's real easy to get off track.
Okay.
You know, and one of the things that y'all have mentioned already is when you start to read about the tax law, or you hear things from news outlets, or even things like this, be really, really careful about what you think the application is going to be to your situation. Because unfortunately, there are an awful lot of ifs, ands, and buts, and maybes in the tax law. And one thing I learned a long time ago was that if you're dealing with tax law and it seems to be logical, mm-hmm. you're probably wrong. Because taxes just aren't logical. And so get some professional help. Between now and April the 15th, it's really hard for tax preparers because of the tax deadline. But after April 15th, take some time, meet with your tax professional, talk about how the new law is going to affect you and what you need to do in order to be prepared for next year. There may be some opportunities, especially if you've got a business. Among the things that I think are going to have a significant effect to people that we do tax returns for is that in the itemized deductions, in the past, if you were an employee and you had unreimbursed employee expenses, whether it's mileage driven in your car or travel, motels, meals, those kinds of things, you got to take a deduction for them. Well, beginning in 2018, that deduction is going to go away. And so it could be a very significant tax increasing item for those people.
I know somebody who's going to be a big tax problem for us, my husband. Mm. He deducts a lot of expenses like that.
Yeah. That tended to be an item of interest to the IRS and audits, those mm-hmm. employee business expenses.
Right.
So, now they won't have that reason to audit you, but more than likely, those people who are able to take advantage of that are going to have to restructure, redo somehow in order to maintain that same tax liability.
What about gifting? That's a lot of my clients ask all the time about gifting, and I always get asked, oh, but. You know, you're going to get taxed if you gift over $14,000 per year. And I say, no, you know, that's not how it works. Were there any changes to gifting laws?
There were.
Okay, what are the changes to gifting laws?
Well, first off, be aware that we're talking about two different kinds of tax.
Okay.
Whenever there's
an income tax versus gift tax.
Right. Anytime there's a gift, it's not taxable to the recipient. If you gave your son $1 million,
right,
he doesn't have to pay income tax on that gift.
Right.
Ever.
Gotcha.
You don't get a deduction for that.
Okay.
But it's called a taxable gift.
Okay.
It's a gift for gift tax purposes, it's a taxable gift.
Okay.
And so when you get to gift tax, it's an entirely different set of rules to determine whether there's a tax liability or not.
Okay.
Clear as mud.
I get it.
All right. So that's
nobody's taxed as income. It's not considered income. It's a gift. So we're in the gift tax rules. So we look at the gift tax rules.
That's right. And for gift taxes, as long as your estate is worth less than $11.5 million,
right,
or $24-25 million, if you've handled it correctly and prepared their wills and the documents correctly, then even though it is a taxable gift. For gift tax purposes, there will never be any tax that has to be paid.
Right.
Okay. So it's
important. But it does, now I know in the rules previous, however, the reason it was taxable, or the reason you had to report it, is because it would deduct from how much you could gift further during your life, or in death, which they were tied together. Okay, for instance, the $11.5 million, okay? If I gave away $2 million to you right now, right? Which we'll do after the show, okay?
Okay.
A couple suitcases.
And y'all heard that.
Okay.
I did.
And when I give you that, I've got to report that to the IRS as a gift. You don't get taxed for it.
Right.
But it gets deducted from the 11.5 I could give away for the rest of my life. So now I can only give away 9.5 without incurring a tax penalty.
That's correct.
And that 9.5 follows through to when I pass away, so then I can give away $9.5 million if I don't give away any more during my life, when I die.
Or if you don't give it away and your beneficiaries inherit it, before it's inherited, it's subject to tax. As long as your assets at death don't exceed $9.5 million, there's no estate tax.
Correct.
But if it exceeds...
Or 11.5 if I hadn't given away $2 million already.
Right.
We're assuming I still gave away $2 million. Yeah.
But if you...
You can pay me back then for paying your taxes.
Okay.
If you do have an
excess... Pay your tax.
At a rate of 40% or higher.
That's the gift tax.
That's the tax.
For all you decamillionaires and above out there, right? With right. 10 million or above. You like that, decamillion? Right. So then... Call me, free consult, okay? Right, and we'll do all your planning, okay? No, really, it's there are ways though to set up trusts, like you were mentioning, where it diverts into a credit shelter trust and say a Q-tip trust. There's a couple of different ways to divert that money, split it, so that you still don't, right? So if you do your tax planning right, you could double that exemption because it splits it into two separate trusts. IRS is aware of that, it's all under their rules. And that way you could still avoid the tax. So really whatever the IRS amount is, that 11.5 stated, you could double to 23 million, yeah.
24 really.
11.5. Okay.
11.5
times 2 is 23. I don't do much with numbers.
So there you go. So anyway, so you could double that and, excellent. So that's what I thought it was anyway. That's how I understood it either. What was the change?
Well, the change was that the limit was about $5.5 million, and it doubled to $11.5 million.
Gotcha. So that's what I thought. Yeah, so it went because used to it was like $11 million total for a couple, right?
So
but now it's $11.5 million per individual.
That's federal.
That's huge.
That's federal.
Okay, state is totally different.
In North Carolina, the state follows the federal, so at least until this new law, anyway, the state has followed the federal. And I don't know what North Carolina has done at this point, but I would hate to assume that they would follow and then they not. But
so they may follow or they may keep the same?
They or may not. At one time, the federal limit was $1 million and the state was $100,000. Mm-hmm. So it was a has been different in the past.
It would be different as an attorney planning for people under those rules.
Mm-hmm.
Much different.
Exactly.
Right. There's much more planning that needs to be done because tax planning needs to be a part of that.
Exactly.
Right. Much more.
The gifting rules have changed in that in 2018 you can gift $15,000 per recipient per year. So that has gone up. with your grandchildren going to college, you can take your money up to $250,000 and make a tax-free gift to them into a 529 plan.
Okay.
And that 529 plan can then pay your grandchildren's college expenses.
Now I just need to find where I can make the $250,000
in the bills. Well, it gives you the $2 million here after the, or you've got
to. But I've got to pay his taxes, yeah. So this is all getting very mathematical.
Yes.
So that, I mean, that concerns me as far as gifting, and because I have a lot of clients who worry about gifting and the taxes, because there's that, and back to that $14,000 number. In the past, you know, last year it was $14,000, correct?
Right.
Okay, is it that way this year too?
For 18, it's 15.
15,000, okay, so it's 15,000 now, thank you. So it's up to 15,000, and they think, it used to, it was 10,000 for a long time. Mm-hmm. But if I give over that, I'm gonna have to pay tax. No. If it's over $15,000 this year, you could give away below $15,000 to everybody in town and not report that anywhere, correct?
You would need to report it on your gift tax return.
Okay.
Just to allow the government to know that now your $11.5 million exemption has gone down.
Gotcha.
As you were talking about earlier.
But I thought if you gifted out below the $15,000 limit, that you didn't have to report that.
You don't have to.
Okay.
But once your total gifts exceed...
Total gifts exceed 15. I thought it was 15 per person.
You need to consider, it is. It's $15,000 per recipient per year.
Gotcha.
Before you have to report it.
Yes.
But you would want to keep up with how much you've given to different people.
Okay. But that $15,000 doesn't mean you hit some kind of taxable event.
No.
Because you didn't.
No.
So... a lot of people I meet with think that I can't get, but can I give out this? No, yes, you can give out a lot more than that if you wanted to.
A lot of people we didn't meet ask the same question.
Right.
My mother gave me $20,000.
Right.
How much tax do I have to pay on it?
Right.
So that's a real common question. Once again, it's just a misunderstanding between the type of tax.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Excellent. Thank you for clearing those things up.
Well, yeah.
Updating our
You
numbers.
Did a good job.
Thank you.
You understand it pretty well.
You taught me. You taught it to me quite a few years ago.
You're learning.
I should.
Yeah.
Is there anything else that stands out that people might not know to ask about?
There's a couple of things in the business area that are going to change that will probably be a surprise to folks when they learn about it. Up until this year, a business could deduct entertainment expenses, mm-hmm. like tickets to ball games or
right.
to the theater. Beginning in 2018, those expenses aren't deductible any longer. Meals expenses are still deductible, but only 50% of the meal is deductible. That's been around for a long time.
Mm.
And one other thing that we see a lot is that there was an award program that was tax-free to employees for length of service or safety.
Mm-hmm.
They could receive a non-cash award of up to
$400.
And many people use gift cards, gift certificates, and those kinds of things. Well,
Forget about that.
The award...
Thanks, Robbie.
You're welcome.
Now,
actually, it goes up to $1,600.
Oh, it went up to $1,600 per employee?
Ooh,
that's my plan. But now, beginning in 18, those gift cards, gift certificates, those kinds of things can't be used. That's considered cash now. So you can't get those gift cards.
So you can do non-cash.
You can do non-cash.
But gift cards don't even.
So we can still go just the symphony on the tickets or the...
Can't give tickets, there's gift cards, gift certificates.
What about saving farm bills? I can give them...
Lodging.
I can give them $1,400 or $1,600?
Well, I wouldn't do more than $400.
$400 worth of books.
Yeah.
Yay.
Or coffee or whatever.
Can't give food.
Is coffee a food?
All right. So there's going to have to be some research done on what you're
putting into it.
Maybe you could do something like your employee could go to Kmart or Walmart and buy what they put something on layaway.
Right.
And then you, as a business owner, can go down and pay for that
layaway. I don't want to get in any gray areas, okay? So you know what? I'm just going to buy you books, okay?
Oh,
so you're
going to
get $400 worth of savings on books.
Okay, that's good.
And art. I'm going to draw you some pictures too.
Oh, okay. You can personalize each one.
I will.
Yeah,
I
and
will.
Maybe you and Tucker and do cartoons and things, so we'll figure it out.
So those are some areas in the business. The business area has got one real complication in the pass-through income that's going to go from businesses to the owners of the business. They're going to allow a 20% deduction of that on the personal return, which is, if you were doing your tax return on a postcard, it would be real easy if it were that simple. But of course, that 20% of income is not just 20% of income. There's a number of limitations and ifs, ands, or buts that may or may not change that 20%. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be a real complicated area that we're still studying at this point.
I definitely think my husband's going to have to come
see you. Anything else that you think would be just a hot topic that people need to know about the 2018 tax law?
I think the biggest thing is
pay your taxes.
Don't wait until next January or February to start thinking about it.
Right.
That's what I mean.
April the 16th or 17th, well, actually we have until April the 18th this year to file. So on April the 19th or 20th, then start calling and make an appointment with your tax professional. Go by and talk with them.
So call them early and often to get advice and get yourself in good shape from the beginning of the year, not waiting to the end.
Exactly.
To do what's called tax, because I just draw a distinction. That's tax planning versus tax preparation.
That's right.
Okay. I mean, because you don't want to end up at the end of the year saying, "I got to pay what?" You know, try to plan ahead of time so you can avoid paying what. You know, avoid that.
Yeah. Tax professionals are really tuned in to trying to help their clients save money.
Yes.
But after December the 31st. There's only two or three things that can be done.
Right.
But prior to that time, spend a little bit of time and let that person help you get things lined up so that you reduce your liability as low as you can.
Robbie, if somebody needed to call and ask you a question or make an appointment, how would they get in touch with you?
You can call me at Business Consulting Group in Shelby. Our phone number is 704-487-0638. Our website is www.B as in boy, C as in Charlie, groupinc.com. Give us a call, ask questions. We do a free consultation for the first visits. We'd be happy to talk to anybody who has any questions, try to help them down the right path.
Sure. Thank you for being here.
My pleasure.
I always appreciate all the knowledge you bring. Thank you for teaching me. And I'll tell you, when I'm with a client and they get into an area that has to do with a tax professional that's outside of my knowledge or my area of expertise, I know to stay in my lane, and I send them to you, or I send them to someone who can answer the question. You know, I mean, that's just part of the job, is picking who knows what subject. You know, and
getting things are so complicated. I'm the same way when it comes to legal issues,
right.
And unfortunately, in the tax business is. You know, almost a branch of the legal profession. And so we run into so many things that I just don't want to get into. I'm going to look to you to answer those questions.
Sounds good. Okay. Thank you very much. And a little known fact before we leave, former Washington Redskin, Robbie Reynolds. He used to play for the Washington Redskins.
For 2 weeks.
For two. I'll give a cash reward for anybody who can get me a Robbie Reynolds jersey from the Washington Redskins.
That's going to be really, really hard because there really wasn't one.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you have it.
Well, thank you for coming. Thank you, Taylor. Thank you, Hayden.
Yeah, this was great.
All right.
Thank you.